Today, I'm going to ask you for a little bit of a different challenge. But before we get to that, let me first present you the problem. So we're going to start with a circle, which has the area of 4 pi. Then we're going to divide the circumference of our circle into 3 identical circular arcs. Then we're going to find the exact midpoint of all of those 3 arcs. Then, from those midpoints, we're going to construct the arcs, which are going to have the same radius as the radius of our circle, and they're going to pass through the center of the circle, as you can see on the sketch. In this way, we will form this really nice symmetrical red shape, which I'm going to call the flower. So, the question is, can you somehow calculate the area of this red flower? This problem was presented to me by one of my subscribers, Matt_D. So thank you, Matt, for this wonderful suggestion. Of course, now here comes the fun part. You can try this problem for yourself, of course, but I will urge you this time to try to find a different solution from 2 solutions which I'm going to offer you today. I'm just really curious to see how many of you can come up with a new idea or new approach to this problem. Of course, when you do this, write it down in a comment section below. Alright, so I'm going to offer you 2 different methods to solve this problem, and the first method will be using segment and the sector. So, since we know the area of the circle, let's first find its radius. We know that the area is equal to pi r squared, so we can say that pi r squared is equal to 4 pi, which means that r squared is equal to 4, which means that the radius of our circle must be equal to 2. Alright, so now let's have a look at the petals of our flower. This shape of one petal of this flower is actually called a circular lens in geometry. And the best way to find this circular lens is to divide our petals with the radius of a circle into 2 identical segments, as you can see on the sketch. Now, we're just going to have a look at one of those segments. Now, let's have a look at this radius of our circle with the value of 2. If we pull this radius all the way up and down, you can see that the bottom side of this formed triangle must be equal to the radius of this circle, so it must have the length of 2. The same thing applies for the vertical line of this triangle, since this is also the radius of the circle. Therefore, we can conclude that this triangle is actually an equilateral triangle. And now, let's just have a look at this shape that we got. As you can see from this shape, we can calculate our red shape if we subtract our whole shape from the equilateral triangle. Now, in geometry, this red shape, which represents the half of the petal of our flower, is actually called a circular segment. The whole shape will be circular sector, and, of course, we have equilateral triangle. So we're just going to subtract the area of the circular sector from the area of the equilateral triangle. Let's first focus on a circular sector. You can see that it has the radius of 2, and we know that the central angle of this sector must be 60 degrees. We know this because this is the part of the equilateral triangle. Now we can use the formula for the area of the circular sector, which is pi r squared times the central angle over 360 degrees. We can substitute our values from the sketch and simplify a little bit to get 4 pi over 6, which can be even more simplified to 2 pi over 3. Alright, so now let's try to find the area of our equilateral triangle with the side of 2. The area of the equilateral triangle is equal to the side squared times square root of 3 over 4, so we will just substitute the value for our side. We're going to simplify 2 squared and 4, and we will get that the area of this triangle is equal to square root of 3. Now, let's translate this into the formula. we can say that the area of our circular segment is equal to 2 pi over 3 minus square root of 3. And now with this, we have the area of the half of the petal of the flower. But if you remember correctly, 6 of those areas will be equal to the area of our flower. So we will just multiply this area with 6, and we can simplify and get that the area of our red flower is equal to 4 pi minus 6 square root of 3 squared units, and this is our solution. Of course, you can approximate this to a number if you want to, but I'm going to leave it as it is. Now, before I show you the second method, which is going to be an awesome one, this would be a great time for me to invite you to like the video or subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed the content so far. Alright, so let's now do the second method, which is going to be a really interesting one, and we're going to use the blooming of a flower. So we're going to start our approach the same way as we did in method number one, and we're going to calculate the radius of this circle the same way, and we will get, of course, that this radius is equal to 2. Now we will again divide the petals of our flower the same way, symmetrically, as we did in our previous method. But this time we will do something a little bit different. We will think about the blooming of a flower, and we will translate this idea into our sketch. Now we will bloom our flower up until the edges of the circle, and we will do this for the rest of the flower as well. And as you can see, the half of the petals of our flowers will be perfectly aligned to the circumference of our circle. This is, of course, possible because the radius of those petals is the same as the radius of our circle. And in this way, we will form this really nice regular hexagon in the middle of our circle. We know that this is the regular hexagon because all the sides of this hexagon are equal to the radius of our circle, which is equal to 2. Now, all that we need to do to find our red area is just to subtract the area of our circle from the area of the regular hexagon. And that's it. Now, let's translate this into the formula. We can say that this area is equal to the area of the circle, which is pi r squared. But, of course, we already know that this is 4 pi from the condition of our problem. But you can calculate it either way if you want to, it really doesn't matter, minus the area of the regular hexagon, which is equal to 6 times the area of an equilateral triangle. Because, just to remind you, the regular hexagon is actually made out of 6 equilateral triangles, so therefore we have this formula. Now, we're just going to use this formula and we're going to substitute our values. Now we're going to simplify the right side a little bit, and we're going to get the same solution of 4 pi minus 6 square root of 3 squared units, and again we have our same solution. Alright, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem. And remember, the challenge this time is to find a completely different method from those that I have shown you here. And if you do this, write them down in the comment section below. And again, as always, until next time, see you all and take care.